Genesee, Genesee, Khaleesi, je ne sais quoi. Now that I've annoyed fans of the brewery and everyone from Rochester, let's get to the beers. We have Genesee Light, Genesee Beer, and Genesee Cream Ale. Before we dive in here, I want to give Jim from Matter of Craft a big shout out, not only for having all of these beers with the light and the beer being big surprises here, but for the very pleasant conversation that we had nerding out about beer. First up, we have Genesee Light. Introduced in 1974, made with 2 and 6 row pale malt, corn grits, unspecified Yakima Valley hops, special bottom fermenting yeast, and water. Alcohol content is 3.6%. So I poured it, it's super fizzy. It sounds like soda. Carbonation is very high on this. It's still kind of bubbling away quite a bit here. All right, let's go ahead and have a look at it. So it is a very, very pale crystalline yellow, but there is quite a lot floating around in there, actually. There's lots of little particulates. So now I'm going to jump into a little bit of the Genesee history. We're going to sprinkle that through this video. Genesee was just one of many pre-Prohibition breweries operating in Rochester, which has a rich German heritage, really good access to malts and adjuncts through the Genesee River Valley, and several population booms that helped it grow. One was from the opening of the Erie Canal, and through trading it became a hop-growing powerhouse, and then later an influx of German immigrants in the 1840s, when a dozen more breweries were opened up. The brewery had many different names as it's been sold and bought, integrated and separated from the many companies over the years, but it managed to survive all of those transitions and prohibition, which killed the Rochester brewing scene. So let's go ahead and have a smell. So there's really just a kind of a light cereal and light corn character here. If I had to describe it, it would be very neutral. I'm struggling to pick up any sort of hop character whatsoever. All right, let's go ahead and have a taste. Cheers. Well, it's a bit like our light beers that we've had before. There's very, very minimal flavor. It's kind of like cereal, slightly cereal flavored soda. It's super light in the body. Bitterness is pretty low. It might be skirting the moderate side of the spectrum. Carbonation is pretty high. It's not especially lively. It kind of dies. The feel is pretty lean. It's got a pretty strong watery character to it, which is why I said it's kind of like cereal soda. The finish is really dry and pretty clean, actually. So well done on some of that. But it is a light beer. That is for sure. As this is warming up a little bit, there's kind of a straw character, and there's even like a little kiss of a bread note, but it's all very faint. This has very minimal character to it, so each one of these is kind of difficult to pick through. Kind of a nondescript citrus character that's coming through a little bit, and there is a bit of a metallic tang. Yeah, I don't really want to see where this goes as it gets any warmer. It's not getting much better. It's getting progressively worse with each degree that it gets warmer. Yeah, definitely drink this as cold as possible and drink it as fast as possible. Next up, we have Genesee beer, or just Genesee. Introduced in 1878, made with 2-row pale malt, corn grits, unspecified Yakima Valley hops, yeast, and water. Alcohol content is 4.5%. All right, again with this one, when you pour it, lots and lots of bubbles, very high carbonation. It sounds like soda. So let's go ahead and have a look at it. So it's got that same color, but there is a pretty significant amount of particulate in here. It's not perfectly crystal clear. Okay, so I said I'd talk about the history, so we're gonna pick up a little bit later on down the road. So after Prohibition, Genesee established High Falls Brewing Company as its craft beer subsidiary in 1995. After a management-led buyout reorganization, Genesee was integrated into the High Falls Brewing Company name from 2000 to 2009. In 2009, High Falls was bought by KPS Capital Partners and organized under North American breweries alongside Labatt USA, Magic Hat, and Pyramid. It regained its original Genesee name that same year. North American Breweries was bought by FIFCO through one of its subsidiaries in 2012. All right, let's go ahead and have a smell. So this has much more of a traditional, like, lager, American lager character to it. There's a slightly sweet, like, white bread, sliced white bread character. What is going on with my nose? There is kind of a cracker character too. It's not really like Ritz cracker. It's not really quite saltine. So there's a bit of a grassy note immediately from this, unlike the light, which I really had to hunt for any sort of hop character whatsoever. This one, it's very much still in the background, but it's prominent from right from the pour instead of having to wait for it to warm up a little bit. I really should have got a water before I started this one. All right, let's go ahead and have a taste. Cheers. Not too bad, actually. Still very light, like the previous one. Bitterness is, I would say, on the very low end of moderate. Carbonation is still pretty high. The feel doesn't have that lean character to it. It's actually like kind of firm. There's not really like a strong watery texture. I would say that it falls pretty strongly in the crisp classification. And then the finish is pretty dry and clean, actually. So all in all, pretty solid. Still, I think the bread note is probably the most dominant, with like a cracker note and then sort of the grassy, herbally, earthy hop character underneath all of that. It's a little bit harder to pick out. There's something else there too. I guess it is almost kind of a green apple-y or pear kind of thing going on with it. Oh yeah, I'm starting to pick up a corn. There's definitely corn coming up a lot more as this warms up. It was more about that bread character straight out the gate, but now that corn is starting to just like overtake everything. It does do a pretty good job as far as the like drinking experience, feel, like texture, all of that of American lager, better than some of its larger macro commercial alternatives. But like the light, I'm liking it less as it warms up. I know I like it more than the light, but I think the light set the bar pretty low. All right, next up, we have the cream ale. Introduced in 1960, made with 6-row pale malt, corn grits, unspecified Yakima Valley hops, yeast and water. Multi GABF winner, 2 years back to back. Alcohol content is 5.1%. All right, just like the other two, pretty significant carbonation, very soda-like. And I guess also one of the things I didn't mention, the head on pretty much all of these, almost uniform bubbles. All right, let's go ahead and have a look at it. Same color as the other ones. There is still sort of that floating particulate going on there. So otherwise it would be crystal clear. So for those of you that don't know what a cream ale is, it doesn't include like lactose or anything like that. Cream ale is just an ale that undergoes an extended lagering or cold conditioning. There are some examples that use a lager yeast during the conditioning stage, or use a blend of ale and lager yeast during the fermentation. You get kind of the speedy turnaround of an ale with the much cleaner character of a lager. It's also probably the most well-known example of cream ale, which is a style that originated entirely from the United States. It was not the first cream ale, but it is certainly the one that popularized the style. Our great northern neighbors in Canada helped carry the torch for this style during Prohibition. Basically everything that I've ever heard about this beer is it's much beloved by anybody who is from the Rochester area and drinks beer. Seems to be like their kind of pride and joy. But also I've heard from a lot of people that this was kind of like a proto craft for some of the older beer drinkers as well. So I've heard the story many times where people got introduced to Genesee, mostly the cream ale, but their other beers by extension, and eventually ended up getting into craft. The big claim to fame with this beer is that there's an extra krausening, which is a process of carbonating the beer with wort rather than priming sugar. So any of you who have ever homebrewed before know what I'm talking about. But essentially, when you carbonate a beer, you can force carbonate it with CO2. You can carbonate it with priming sugar, which is usually done with like a cane sugar or a honey or something high in sugar like that, added to the beer just before bottling. All right, let's go ahead and have a smell. So very similar character to the beer that we just had before, the previous one. It still has that white bread, crackery kind of thing going on there. But there's a little bit of like a, I guess it's almost like a biscuit character. It's almost leaning more toward that. There's kind of like a floral character. I'd say also the bread character leans less toward a actual white bread and more doughy. So there is that same sort of earthy, grassy kind of hop character as the previous one as well. There's also the same like fruity, apple-y character going on too. All right, let's go ahead and have a taste. Cheers. So this is still pretty light bodied, but there's even a little bit more heft to it than the previous two. And I'd say the bitterness is sort of on par with the previous beer as well. It's in that like the lower end of moderate to the higher end of low bitterness. Carbonation is high. It's in the same, basically the carbonation across all three of these is the same. There's a little bit more of a creamier texture to the feel of this beer. So it's still pretty crisp like the previous one was. Finish is still dry like the other two, but not nearly to the same degree. It's maybe like a notch or two less dry. Going back and smelling it too, there's a little bit more of like a honey note as well. And the corn is there too. It seems like the corn takes a little bit after the pour for it to kind of pop up. I'd say this one is the most characterful out of the bunch and pretty similar to the previous one as far as the tasting is concerned. It's not a great beer, but it's not, and actually pretty much all of these are not great, but they are, I can kind of understand where people are coming from liking this as sort of their regional beer, but also being introduced to better beer through this, because this one in particular has a lot more character to it than the beers you typically think of when you think of larger breweries in the United States. Yeah, I don't love it, but I also don't really hate it. All right, well, thank you for joining me for this tasting comparison. I'm not gonna say that there's like necessarily a best. It was more about exploring the lineup of Genesee. But as far as my favorite is concerned, I would say that it's probably the cream ale. There are still flaws in pretty much all three of these, but the cream ale was the one I was most excited to try. It was really fun to get a comparison between all three, and I'd actually be interested to try more of Genesee's beer, but I don't think I'll be able to find any more of their stuff out this way. Well, I think that about does it for this tasting, but if you want to check out some more, why not look over here? Cheers, and thanks for watching. I just want to state for the record, I stole the Khaleesi thing from Cheap Beer Corner, but I came up with the rest myself. I'm coming clean.